The squad making sure we all win. Smoke a lot radio, we going all in. Zilla, I'm the host with the most smoke. Rolling up the most dope. Kato got the most jokes. Simone Taylor, keep it sexy for the grown folks. I'm OG, tone low, bouncing on them ghost folks. Smoke, we the number one podcast. Some other shows, all trash. Amber Rose, all ass. Broadcasting live from the coast. Sick committee with the jokes. Come and get your ass broke.
Being from Compton, you know, most of the hoods is kind of like by each other, but like not a lot of, especially in this day, and that day, wasn't no allies like that. How did going to rapping like Compton Compilation, y'all, all the niggas that's from different hoods even get along off the music shit, or did y'all put the hood shit to the side?
For the love
Compton
of hip-hop.
Compton is right there by each other.
For
niggas
the
is,
love of hip-hop, because at the end of the day, versus today, you know what I mean? Back then, you was either trying to rap, or you was trying to ball, or you was trying to do something to get out the hood. Mm-hmm. Versus today, cats, they bring the gangbang to the money. You know what I mean? We was trying to motherfucking get out that shit. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, we had likers of other people that was on the same thing. Like, they just want to bust and tell their story. You know what I mean? So it wasn't really about pressing nobody or gangbanging and all that type of shit. Actually, we all became good friends and still friends to these days.
So during this whole uprising, you end up going to jail.
Yes, sir.
Like, explain that situation, bro.
Straddling, you know what I mean? A young kid from Compton, California, one leg in, one leg out. You know what I'm saying? And had to learn that you can't do both, because both of them, you know, deserves full attention.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right, right.
So as a young kid, you know what I mean? I didn't know that. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, you know what? I'm rapping. I got a couple of dollars. But I'm hood rich. I'm in the turf.
My mom,
you know what I'm saying?
You know what
I mean? And I'm hanging and I'm doing all this extra turf type shit. But, you know, nigga, a rapper and shit. You know what I mean? So it's like, man, I had to figure out which one I want to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it took me a couple of times. I kept going to prison. Because one thing about California, when you go to prison the second time or something like that, it's basically because of the first time. It's called your priors.
Prior.
You know what I mean? So even if I walked in the store and stole a Snicker bar, and I'm on parole, I'm not going to jail for the Snicker bar. I'm going to jail for the shit that happened before. You feel me? You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So
right. It's a prior.
That's what I was caught up
in. So you had a lot of priors, and that's what made you have to lay it down for a minute.
The same night we did the duck sick, I got gaffed.
Fuck out of here.
The exact same night. I left.
So you left the studio and got pulled over.
Left from bopping that song, jumped in the car, jumped in a G-Rod, homie, a stolen car.
Oh, no. And, we really are in the hood.
Off. Yeah.
Was that the It's a Compton Thing album?
That's the It's a Compton Thing album, yep.
The but Blue you tape. Got a whole record deal when you in a G-Ride.
I'm in a G and a Maxima.
You know, really back got in them the days, in it.
The Maxima was clean back in the day.
Hell clean, the legend. The Maxima,
you know, you
legend.
Open the door and it go ding, 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 you know what I'm saying? One of them.
Yo,
you know
the two-tone joints with the burgundy and the tan at the bottom.
I called Porter Butter, I stole that motherfucker from my. For my mama,
you stole that. No, that's the Acura. The Acura Legends, I think.
What?
No, the car I'm talking about.
The Acura. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's no, the Acura. Acura. Yeah. No, the Maximum was the square joint.
The Maximum was the other joint.
That's the first car I talked to you.
Was the other joint.
You know what I'm saying? But I stole a motherfucker from my mama's job. She worked at Long Beach Memorial in Long Beach. And you know, I ain't had shit to do. You know what I mean? I wasn't just at her job. I just ended up at her job. You know what I mean?
So hold on, man. Was you a hot wire specialist?
No,
how
I
did you steal
that.
The car?
Easy gang. Look.
Yeah, give us a gang.
Go to the valet parking back then, snatch a gang of keys, and walk through the parking lot,
and hit the lottery.
Ugh, nigga, I got a Maxima.
That's all you did. That's hella easy.
So was it like somebody distracted the nigga while somebody grabbed the keys sometime?
He over here chasing cars, man. You know what I'm saying? We gone with like 10 pair of keys chirping in the
kids, don't try this at home. This is all alleged.
Wow, that's a
I did it. I went to jail, so I advise you not to do it.
Do not.
Too many cameras now anyway. You can't get away with shit.
Really don't fall in love with the car. I'm all at Venice Beach in the motherfucker.
How long you had it? How long you had it?
Shit, I had that motherfucker for like a month.
No, you had the maximum for money, boo boo.
Tipping.
Oh, Lord. That was yours. That was yours.
I was on fresh.
All
candy.
The niggas in the hood hitting donuts.
I started getting breaks.
Yeah, about a good 10,000 in my pocket, fresh khakis. You know, at the studio.
Fresh
get
khakis.
The duck sick. We do the duck sick. You know what I'm saying? I leave, go try to take this young lady I was dating at the time.
No, you got pulled over with the young chick.
Nah, I'm trying to take her some medicine, trying to school to her house.
Doing some good guy shit.
Right. This is when they stopped putting the headlights right here and started putting them right here. You know what I mean?
At the
on
time.
The blinker. You know what I'm saying?
The
fuzz pull on me and say, hey, stupid, why you ain't got your lights on? I said, oh, I'm tripping. And I'm like, God damn, where the lights at?
Don't you know what I'm saying? Like where they was at.
You know, and I got the fumbling, you know what I mean? And I found it like, oh, by that time, he done veered back, jumped behind me, blurped me. I'm like, okay, nigga.
After a month, you didn't know where the lights was at.
Oh, just pull over, you know what I'm saying?
Over, right.
I ain't even got to pull
Chill.
Over, I just stopped.
After a month, you didn't know where the lights was at?
I did not know. I did not know.
My dick.
I swear I did.
And that's so that tell you
what caliber of nigga I was. You know what I'm saying? I was
he didn't give a fuck.
Idiot.
He did
you
not know where the lights was and ride that motherfucker at night.
You know?
America's dumbest shit.
Real
dumbest criminal. You know, and
world's
you know,
dumbest criminal.
And he was looking out for somebody is what got him caught.
Yeah,
that's the moral
to
of the story.
Take some motherfucking Pepto-Bismol or some shit.
The moral of the story, he'd be like, man, fuck these bitches.
Man.
He wouldn't even got caught and he had
man,
it for 2 months.
Health is wealth,
hey,
man.
Don't be judging me.
Health is wealth.
Health is where he's looking out for her tummy, her stomach.
But hold on, you sat it down for hella years. That's what you sat it down for.
No, actually, that first time I went and unknown got me out. I got out, shit, I got out probably like about 45 days, some dumb shit like that.
Right.
But then, you know, I'm still riding around doing my thing. Now I got my own car. I got a Regal, a 79 Regal.
On my mom.
With super beating and all I bump is KRS-One. Every day, all I had was 215s in that motherfucker. No highs with a big ass bullet hole in the side of this motherfucker. And I'm
that's called a tattoo, y'all. Back in the day,
so
niggas' cars had tattoos.
I'm about to fall out the window in this motherfucker.
Nigga,
you know what I'm saying?
Crack window something, nigga. Show me the struggle.
You know, I kept a gun with me, you know. Buzz, get on.
As you should.
Me with the gun. Prior from stealing the car, now I got a gun. Boom, now I got to go do a year county lit. Got out, still didn't learn my lesson. Got caught with a pistol again. Fell in with a gun. Boom, okay, man, you ain't learning.
Got to go get a number now, nigga.
Yeah.
And this all when y'all making the comments.
This is
most
all
wanted
while
shit.
We making the CMW record.
We come strapped, or before
we
that.
We come strapped. I came home right before we did music the drive-by.
Chill one with the class.
And that's how I end up being 8 majority on that project. You know what I mean? And 8 Mike T on the front. I'm on the inside. You know what I mean?
So, you found a way to get it cracking.
Well, at that time, I had to think about what I was going to do. Because me and Ada Mac, you know what I'm saying? We always talk while I was gone.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, just keep riding. So when I get home, I got something to do. You know what I'm saying? So I never was the type, you know, to be mad that he went on to do this and do that. Mm-hmm. I'm like, man, keep riding. So when I come home, I got something to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I came home.
Well,
we kept
the name cracking.
Yeah. I'm like, what can I do? What can I do? Start doing beats. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Start
Hold
doing
on,
beats.
Man. How did you learn how to do beats? And one more thing before I say that, he kept it lit how Bun B kept Pimp C lit.
Right.
He was locked up.
Right.
Now, let's go to how you start creating beats. Who put you on? Because let me give it a little story. Mm-hmm. I wish I could learn the technology about making beats.
That shit was dope.
Now, me, I came from marching bands. I'm a bass player.
Mm-hmm.
Bass drum player, I'm a snare player, I'm a trumpet player.
Dope.
So that's, all
that's
them elements.
Beats.
Talented motherfucker right there.
So I co-produce a lot of my shit, but I don't know how to computerize it and all
technology.
That.
Technology.
Boom.
For
so
me, you know
how
what I'm
did
saying?
You get the link and how to know how the technology and all that, bro?
Man,
who put
look,
you on?
It's just like playing a video game. I was a dude that always used to play Sega. Man, I played the first Madden to the new Madden now on the
Pac-Man. You didn't play no Ninja Gaiden.
I played all that shit.
Ninja Gaiden.
That was a Sega only game.
Hey, look. Yeah.
You only could play Ninja Gaiden on Sega.
All that shit. You know what I mean?
Tecmo Bowl was on fucking Nintendo. Nintendo.
Right. But all that.
Ninja Gaiden was a Sega Genesis.
Get Ronnie Lottie catching from 50 yards out.
You just go right back and just arm that motherfucker.
Dexter Manley.
And then Bo Jackson, you just run Bo
down
Jackson. He running
hit a
niggas
over. Down and A.
Yep.
Bo Jackson running niggas over. You be the Raiders. He was dominating shit.
You know, that's my team.
Bo Jackson just knocking everything down.
Knocking everything down.
So I always been intrigued with, you know, putting shit together, taking shit apart. And as a youngster going to school, I went to school, me, eight, Snoop Dogg, Warren G. You know what I'm saying? Our school was like crush moves.
What school y'all went to, bro?
I went to Long Beach, Georgia.
You just had a knick-knack story. Because Nick Dad just went to school with Yo-Yo and shit in there. And Cube.
And Sir Jinx.
And Sir Jinx and goddamn.
They went to the wash house. Yeah, they was at the wash. You know what I'm saying? We was at the Panthers, Jordan. You know what I mean? The Long Beach.
Oh, man.
And that's right in the north.
Right off that freeway.
So hold on, man. You a Compton nigga in the school in Long Beach, nigga.
But that was like a borderline thing. It was called that, but...
Right across the street. I walked to school every day.
That little area where that school at?
It's like, I don't know the L.A. politics. My bag, my nigga.
Put it this way.
This from the Bay, nigga.
Let me see. Because I know the Bay. How far is Hayward to the O?
Hella far.
Okay, that's I don't know the Bay like that deep.
Nah,
it seemed like it wasn't that far.
No. At the end of the O, it's you got San Leandro that separates.
Put it this way, Frisco to Oakland, that bridge, what's that?
Yeah, that's close.
That's Compton.
So that was it. Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
That was it.
I walk over the bridge on Atlantic, boom, I'm in Long Beach.
Because you got to skip like two cities to get to fucking Hayward. Yeah,
right.
You got to skip San Leandro.
Right. So if you coming from over to Frisco, to over that bridge right there where all them shops and shit at.
San Lorenzo.
Yeah.
All that.
And you right into the O, that's Compton and Long Beach. Same thing. You go over the bridge.
Okay,
and shit,
so y'all was right there.
Right.
Borderline
so me,
shit.
Trayvon Lane from Death Row. The other homie Pop, my nigga Al Will, rest in peace. And hey, we mob from Compton every day to Long Beach. You know what I mean? Met up with Warren G and Snoop. Then Snoop went on and went to school to Polytech on the east side. You know what I'm saying?
So Snoop went, what is this, junior high or high school?
High school.
Hold up.
That's crazy.
What grade was this?
Back then it was 10th, 11th, and 12th.
Yeah, it
wasn't no ninth.
You know what I mean?
It wasn't no ninth.
Yeah, it was 10th, 11th,
and bullshit. So what grade was you in when you met Snoop?
In the 10th.
And what grade was
in? In the 11th. And he was in the 10th.
10th. He was younger than you, right. I assume that.
He was in the 10th because me and 8 came out with this Compton thing in 89. That was it was time to graduate if you was that kind of guy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But Warren used to always be like, man, y'all niggas got a record, man. You know what I'm saying? What's happening, man? You know what I'm saying? I'm like, nigga, I'm a kid. I don't know how to put nobody record. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, ain't Dr. Dre your brother? You know what I'm saying?
Y'all knew that in high school.
You know what I mean? Like,
y'all knew that shit in high school.
Yeah, but you know, he was the homies though. You know what I'm saying?
So you weren't looking at that.
Nobody knew that until like The Chronic came out. Y'all LA niggas
knew that. We knew that.
They need a whole movie with a whole early years, like a series.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, y'all knew that.
Yeah, yeah.
G-Thing video, like, that's my nigga. When he was at the barbecue and shit.
Yep, like, look at Warren, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yep.
And then Regulator come out and smack their ass.
Smack, you know what I'm saying? I was so proud of my nigga.
Back to your story, though, bro. My bad for cutting it off.
Fourth is the beats, you know what I'm saying? Like, my homeboy Wade, he had a drum machine, a little rolling. And his mama, she used to didn't like him fucking with that shit too much. So he only fuck with it at my house. So he would leave it at my house. And I just study it. You know, we didn't have YouTube and all that shit. He showed me a quick 1-2 step. And I just learned from everything from that. Also, I used to always watch DJ Slip. You know what I'm saying? And when he leave and get up from his drum machine, I'm on his drum machine fucking up, erasing beats and all that shit. And he like, what you doing? You done fucked up the beat. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or on all the CMW shit, I'll slide in a break beat or, you know, put these drums with it. You know, sometimes it be dope, sometimes it be whack.
Creative input.
Exactly. You know what I mean? So
on some producer shit.
Once I got my own MPC 60.
It was over.
It was a fucking whack.
You know who gave me my first break? MC Ren.
MC Ren.
It came back full circle.
Rufus gave
it. Was it an MP 12 or was it an MP?
MPC 60. The one with the big pass, the big square one. The first boy. I didn't even know how to separate the monopoly.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't even know how to separate the outs. I'm up at Rufus Studio trying to figure out how to lay this beat. I did the song Shot Caller on a Rufus for Life album. That was the first time I ever had a beat that actually came out on a
on the album.
Level.
Wow.
Yep. And then the next one was the Homeboys Above the Law. Big Hutch, Cold 187, KMG. Oh my mama!